Welcome. In this session, we're going to learn the difference between a formula and a function in Excel. To do so, I've created a basic spreadsheet that's tracking the cost of my textbooks for the fall semester. You can see in column A, I have four classes that I'll be taking, and in column B, the textbook costs for each of those classes. I've duplicated this information in column C, so that I can show you in cell B8 how to create a total using a formula, and then come over here to cell C8 and show you a faster way to do it by using a function. So let's get started. The first thing we want to do is come to cell B8, select that cell, and what we're going to do is create a formula that's going to give us a total of these four textbook costs. We want the answer placed here, so we make sure that that cell is selected. And remember that when using a formula, you always start out with an equal sign. So I'm going to put my equal sign into that cell, and then I'm going to point to the four cells that I want to add, starting with B4. I'm going to select cell B4. Place a plus sign after that because I want to add to it cell B5. Select that cell, add another plus because I want to come down here and add in cell B6. Select that cell with one final plus because my last cell that I want to add is B7. Notice that as I am pointing and clicking on each of these cells, which we call cursor pointing, Excel is building the formula for me. And all I need to do to let Excel know that I'm finished and to ask it to calculate the results of those four cells is to press the Enter key. So I press Enter, and you can see that the total for those four textbooks has been added to cell B8. If I click on cell B8, I can take a look up here at the formula bar, and I can notice that Excel has stored the formula I entered. But of course, we don't want the formula displayed in this cell. We want the answer displayed. The next thing I'm going to do is come over here to cell C8. And I'm going to, in this case, create a function that's going to do the same thing as I did in column B, but it's going to do it much faster. A function is a set of pre-created formulas that come with the Excel program when you purchase it. And in fact, there are over 400 different functions that are provided to you with the Excel program. Where can I find those functions? You come up here to the ribbon tab, you find the word formulas, you click on formula, and you'll see a function library. In that function library, there are 12 different categories of functions that are provided to you. You can see there's logical, financial, there's date and time, and so forth. There's one function that's used more often than any of the others, and that's one that's listed here by itself, and that's called the auto sum function. And you notice when I take my mouse and I lay it on the summation symbol, that Excel provides for me a definition of what that function does. I can see it right below here. So I want to just double check and make sure that that is the correct function I want to use. And once I've determined that, as long as I've selected the cell where I want the answer placed, all I need to do is just click on that function. If you take a look now, what Excel has done is it's basically done all the work for me. So it's realized that I want to add these four cells because the function is sum, meaning add. And it's given me the range of cells that it thinks I want to add. So you can see here it says C4 colon C7. C4 meaning the starting cell, C7 meaning the ending cell, and the colon meaning through. So it's going to add the two cells in between C5 and C6. All I have to do to let Excel know that it's correct is to press the Enter key. Once I do that, you can see I've been provided with the correct answer. Again, when I select cell C8, I come up here to the formula bar, and I can see that my function is being stored. And that whole process was done in a very easy, quick, and efficient way. Hopefully now you understand the difference between a formula and a function in Excel. And I'd encourage you to go to the function library and explore some of the 400 different functions that are provided with the Excel program.